One and another.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Salamancer. And it's about time for us to cast some new video games. I'm joined tonight by Dr. Kino Puppet, probably one of the world's most amazing chat rooms.
How's it going?
It's going pretty good. You know, can't complain. Not too bad.
So.
But, I am looking pretty happy right now, I gotta say, that we've got some awesome games. And, on a map that I think a lot of people may have never seen before, see me stand in. Give us a rundown on that.
But I was supposed to have a video version on my computers, but we are having some uploading issues from my computers, so we'll have that tomorrow night. But basically, CP Stand-In is a three control point map that's kind of a cross between a CP map like Granary and a CP map like Gravel Pit, where all three points are able to be capped at the beginning of the round, and teams duke it out to make sure they get all three capped first, right? The first team to cap all three points wins the round. And then it's played to five, I believe, in ESA this season.
It's absolutely crazy. I've played on this both as 6v6 and as 8v8. Not 8v8, 9v9. You know, Highlander mode. It definitely works, but it works very differently than anything else I have ever seen. So, crazy.
My experience has been very deathmatchy. Mission ends in 30 seconds. With a propensity for not tolerating much off-classing.
Yeah, and I gotta say, our viewers may be a little bit confused. I know it was always hard for me when I first started watching TF2 because I didn't know half the maps. And it is very difficult to understand what's going on when you don't know the map that well. So I will do my best to show you guys. You know, this is our spawn right now for blue, and of course it is directly across the point B. Very close by is spawn for red. And you can walk out, of course, you know, A, B, or C direction. I guess we'll go out towards C first here. You can see there's a bunch of different doors leading out to B, so it's not just the one spawn door. You've got a couple different others, but if we're going to go towards C, you know, we can take that way. We can take straight from spawn. Of course, there's this little CB connector here. Haha, CB. And there's your capture point. C is really enclosed, and is actually, once you hold it, it can be pretty easily defended. But then, yeah, of course, here, you know, we're going to head back towards B, and of course, this is towards blue spawn right there. Taking the tour, you know, on your left you'll see McDonald's. No, just kidding. Oh, crap. Just completely ruined that by clicking the mouse. No. Okay, we were over here. This is where we were. There's our McDonald's. And then this is A. You can kind of sneak around this big rock pillar here, but essentially this is it's a mirror symmetrical map. You can see the spawn on each side of A. And there used to be, yeah, okay, there's this little room back here, too. If you get stuck inside this room at A, you're pretty much toast most of the time. So... That's a thing.
In my experience on this map, the most important point to hold has been B point, because it has a very good vantage point over the chokes that lead to the other two points on the map. Obviously, it's possible to get from spawn to the other points, but having that central ground also provides you high ground onto both of the points and allows you to fairly easily control the flow of the map. For that reason, I think it's going to be very, very important for these teams to fight over B, and we'll usually see that the first initial fight be on B itself, with all six players from each team going there.
Okay, that makes sense. Just make sure you get the high ground, get a bunch of kills, and then you immediately get one cap. Now, the points do cap pretty slowly, and somebody in the stream chat asked if any doors lock once a point is captured. Answer is no. And here's the thing. To win the map, as Shadow Puppet probably said earlier, but I was too busy getting my camera work in order, you do have to hold all three points at once. There's no overtime, so if you you hold A and B, and then you start capping C and they start capping B, well, if you cap C before they cap B, even if they've got a bunch of time on B, it doesn't matter, you still win. So, it's pretty crazy.
Yeah, it really favors a lot of high-depth strategy from each team in making sure that they're always in a great position. Oftentimes on this map you'll see that a team that is moving as a team from one place to another will get ambushed by a team that's in a much better position, caught out of position, and killed. For that reason, it's very, very important to make sure that you only move when you know it's safe, you move your medic very carefully, and you transition as an entire team so as not to get picked off. Because spawns are also fairly slow on this map. They're not really slow, they're not freight last or snake water slow, but they're up there.
Yeah, no, they are slow. You'll see that if the mid-fight lasts a long time and people don't get wiped out right away, there will be another spawn wave coming in to reinforce before the point is captured.
Yes, because the spawn doors are so close to each and every point.
Yep. It's an interesting little map. We'll have to see how the teams like it and how it fares. Of course, people are asking because they're kind of confused about the map, I think. But yes, this is ESEA. This is ESEA IM. Mayhem versus laser beams, as Bunny Zor has pointed out.
Yeah, just going over a little prediction here. I hate to be this guy, but I have to give the tip of the hat to laser beams here. They're looking fantastic this season. 9-1 so far in regular season with such luminaries as Pure, Sean Bud, Z Brian, Lange. Dr. Donut Man, I always pronounce it wrong. Dr. Donut Man, just these players are just fantastic. Ben from Old Avoided,
yeah,
very, very good players. You know, Mayhem's got their own fair share of solid players. Cade, Grimaud, both very competent, solid players with their respective classes.
Pet and Doink, actually, both from 10 points to Giffendorf from last year or last season.
Yeah, Pet a medic with very little experience at the IM level of play, but who has been playing extremely well so far this season and has been supporting his team very well, so he's proven himself. Boink been doing okay at scout, but I think they're just outclassed in every way here in terms of DM and in terms of experience and strategy.
Well, okay.
I've had the pleasure of sitting in with Pure while he was kind of going over map strategy for his own personal uses last season. He was still medic for the experiment, and I have to say he's quite an intelligent guy.
Oh, he certainly is, and he will expect the best out of his team. But one thing I'll say is that after he dropped out of Invite last season, he said that part of the reason he didn't want to be an Invite anymore was that he was just putting too much effort into it, and so I don't know. We may very well see that he puts less effort into it.
Well, he's playing scout now.
Yeah. Well, one thing he says, he really likes off-classing too, so we may see some pretty crazy off-classing coming from him.
Yeah, I don't know how... The sniper sightlines aren't very good in this map. Spy might be okay. There are a lot of corners, so a good pyro might be able to make good use, but other than that, I don't really see much use in off-classes. Heavy's going to be too slow for this map.
I would disagree with that decision about the heavy.
Okay.
Just because, especially for the initial mid-fight, it's so close from spawn, you can walk a heavy out of those doors right away, and he will immediately be useful.
Okay, I will agree with that analysis, that it's such a short distance, but... you will be either sacrificing control of the main area due to the scout, or control of the top because you're missing a soldier. And because of that, your heavy will probably have a very difficult time setting himself up at the midpoint, and probably go down fairly early. Time you'll just be down your main fragging classes, and it will be all downhill from there. Now, that's not to say that a heavy might not work here, because... oftentimes we see on maps that have less of a known strategic base, off-classing like heavy tends to work more effectively because there's not, you know, these scripted out responses to what exactly you should be doing about a heavy showing up at mid. So there is some credence to that. There is no developed metagame, no developed strategy for this map, and that's one of the reasons I'm really excited to see this map, is because I want to see how it evolves between now and when they go to play it at the ESEA LAN in February. If indeed they do play it.
Yeah, that's the thing. This is probably going to be a LAN map. It's crazy.
I think they ban maps at LAN? You were there. Do they have a banning pick at LAN?
I was only there for the last day, so I honestly don't know.
I think the finals are pre-scripted, so...
Okay.
I'll have to ask Eckstein. I'm not entirely sure what the format is for map selection on that, but... if they have some sort of banning pick, I wouldn't be surprised to see a map like this not make it in.
Yeah, I could agree with that.
Unless it turns out to be an actually a really fun map. And since this is only night two of it being played, I'm not sure how it's going to play out. And I'm really waiting to see the invite teams play in this map because, you know, teams like Quantic versus teams like MixUp who play very different styles. I want to see how they do. Of course, Quantic and MixUp aren't going to play this map this week, but I mean, they're both going to be playing this map without playing it together.
You were confusing me here, Shadow Puppet. But it looks like we do have the home team picking their side. It's going to be Mayhem playing the home team. Not that it matters too much. Mayhem versus Laser Beams. You're watching this on X Television. This is Salamancer. I'm joined by Shadow Puppet, and we are watching CP Stand-In, possibly one of the first matches of the week on CP Stand-In, not the first. I think there were a couple yesterday.
I will be watching Bentamid, see what he can do as a demo man. Oh, he's going C. Ooh. This is an interesting strategy. Ooh.
It is an interesting strategy, and it looks like he's immediately setting his Shadow Puppet. We are definitely hearing your keyboard. Yeah, so it looks like there's a big, big capture rate here on point B right now from Mayhem, and that means they're giving up both A and C. Looks like there was no mid-fight. Now Grimaud and, who is that? It's going to be both the soldiers, actually, for Mayhem jumping in here and trying to stop the capture on A, and they have done it so far. C will be capped by, I believe, Ben and possibly, is that Sean Bud or Pure? But there goes...
Sean Bud.
Yeah. This is the problem with doing that that double attack there on A and C. Look what happened. They lost the four players on A.
Yes, and now they don't have B to control. And we might see them kind of vie back and forth for position, but with only one player on B, they're probably not going to attract too much attention there. However, if they do cap B, they're setting up themselves up in a very, very good position, having 2 points in succession like that.
Well, the thing is, now they're getting back capped on C.
Here comes the Uber right onto midpoint, dropping some sticks right onto Dr. Donut Man. Yeah. Very nice play by a Breaker Mod.
Their strategy
on this map.
It is a good strategy that they managed to cap B. You were absolutely right. That's a good one. And wow, Mayhem is doing some pretty good work here, keeping hold of B as well. They're going to have to keep somebody pretty much standing on it, though, because it's very close to getting capped right now. They need to go grab C as well, because they had about halfway up there, and now it seems like something is defending it once again. So far, we have not seen any off-classing either. These players are all pretty much on their main classes, and we do now have Mayhem mostly pushing their players in towards C. They're probably going to get that cap pretty soon. If they can stop the capture on B and hold onto it just for a little bit longer, then they win this round, but it looks like they are going to let B get capped.
So close, too. You know, they only didn't win that round by maybe like 10 seconds there, so we'll see if they can push themselves back onto B here before A is captured, but it looks like they're holding on to that A point. No, they're holding onto that C point, moving out here into B.
Yeah, they're
getting a little mix up.
I was going to say they're turtling up, but that's not what they're doing. They're waiting for the Uber, and now they have it.
Here it comes.
And Dr. Donut Man, this time around, did manage to get back into their spawn. So now A and B are currently held by, what are they called? The Laser Beams, Mayhem recapturing B right now. Mayhem do also hold point C. Pure did take out Pet, so no medic right now for Mayhem, but there goes Dr. Donut Man.
At 97% Uber, that's not going to bode well for his team, as Mayhem caps that B point. Just a little bit more DM here, taking out a few more players, and they might be able to make a move for A.
Yeah, I'm seeing actually Grimaud is there right now. He's laying down some stickies, but he's getting pressured by a scout. Oh, Sean Bud finished off by a pipe to the face, and Abram Mellon here going to help this capture. This could actually be the end. We do see that Laser Beams are pushing in right now. They've got to stop this cap, because if they don't, they lose the round. They've stopped it so far. My camera work is being awful right now because I just don't know this map. But Soldiers jumping in, dealing a lot of damage. Grimaud and Abram Mellon both down, and the medic is running back towards spawn here, so no, they cannot get A.
Yeah, we are seeing a great deal of polish here from Laser Beams in their DM department as they try to cap B here.
Pet is running the Kritzkrieg, and so he's going to bring his soldier back out here. That's going to be Cade, right? Cade. And now he's actually going to use it on the demo man. Can they stop the capture on B? No, they cannot. And actually, if C gets capped here, just this back cap, I don't know, it's going to be really close. They may actually win right now. This is going to be it.
That's it. They got the point. Laser Beams with some good kiting strategy, playing very patiently and waiting for their opportunity to cap that last point, knows the map, knows that so long as a cap's going on, it doesn't matter as long as they get that cap. Very nicely played by the scouts on Laser Beams. Seems this time they're actually going to go try to fight for mid here, as Dr. Donut Man leads his Demo Man up through the connector into AB.
Wow,
Lang's
Dungeon
taken
Defender.
Out Dungeon Defender.
Yeah, he was the first casualty there, walking through a door, ended up eating a lot of spam and just didn't back off. Medic getting pressured, and there goes Pet right now.
Down.
Yep, Sean
3-4
Bud.
3-4 down for Mayhem.
Yeah, Mayhem just got completely wiped out there. So, too bad for them. Point B is going to be captured by the laser beams. They've got to watch out for a soldier and a demo coming at them right now, so they can't afford to spread themselves too thin, but they may have sent their scouts off to start a cap somewhere. Looks like they're actually starting to capture both A and C. They will not get both of them. You can be sure Mayhem's going to push towards one or the other. Looks like that's going to be towards A.
Yeah, Mayhem moves in towards A here, and whoever was capping decides just to nicely back on out, noticing that it's probably worth it to give them A, because then B and C are both captured for laser beams here in a few seconds, and they'll be able to make a good pressure play on to A point.
Yeah, it's looking like that's how it's going to shape up. They do have to be careful about spawners and back caps and all that, and so there basically is no front line. But if there were a front line, it would be here with Dr. Donut Man, and is that Lang? Yes, it is Lang on the soldier. So they're just trying to hold on to this connector right now.
Yeah, watch how they're controlling this connector and the spawn angles here. Pretty much pressuring everybody on Mayhem into sticking around on A for the time being.
Oh, Pet just dropped his Uber to Z Brian. Not good.
This is one of those maps that you just cannot drop Uber. Looks like a soldier's going to rocket in here onto C to try to stop the cap, as A is almost capped. And it looks like the laser beams have done it again with a time 6 on A point, capping that up nice and quick. Very beautifully done by them, holding onto that B point, waiting for the team to make a move from A, and then moving in, separating the enemy team, and pretty much just dominating.
Yeah, now, we did have a question in the stream chat from Retro. Would this be a map where we might actually see the quick fix? Retro, I know where you live. I'm going to come over there, and I'm going to punch you.
What's wrong with the quick fix, aside from the sound it makes?
Shadow Puppet, I don't know where you live, and I'm going to punch you, too. So, point A, going to get captured very quickly here by the laser beams, and they've got one scout on point C. Already, this scout here, that's Pure, going to engage Mayhem, and Mayhem looks like they're a little bit on the back foot here. That scout is screwed right there. Boink, it's taken down. Green Mode's down as well, so no Demo Man for Mayhem. They cannot trap up any of these corridors. Neither can Ben, though. He's dead as well. And Pure trying to deal a little bit of damage there to C, but it looks like it's going to be this time around A and B captured by the laser beams, and then C is where Mayhem is going to make their last stand.
Oh, Dr. Donut Man getting caught alone, going down to 14 health before he pops. They're going to force the Uber here on Mayhem and then probably back out. Dr. Donut Man's going to have be hard pressed to get out safely, but he does indeed. Nicely done by him, knowing exactly when to back out. But they have lost their C point and are losing the A point, and they are completely separated. Donut Man going back to spawn for a little bit of a buff, or for a little bit of a health regen, I mean. And then he's going to try to meet up with his team, but everybody is in shambles here.
Yeah, Sean Bud just tried to defend A. He got taken down. And Ben is in spawn right now. He's going to go try and meet up with the medic here. They're going towards A. They want to stop that cap, and it looks like just barely they did with those soldiers. Ben, bringing up the rear here with his artillery gun. There goes Mayhem, taken out by Pure, and now Ben. What a beautiful air pipe there. Going for a second one, misses that. But Dungeon Defender is actually finished off, I think, by some air needles from Dr. Donut, who is in turn taken down from Cade. And can Ben stop this? He's going to try and pain train him to death. Yes, he does.
There he goes. Nice pain train from Ben after a beautiful 2, maybe 3K there from Cade, showing his worth on this team. Now it seems that the laser beams are actually maybe in a little bit of trouble here, as all of the points have a little bit of red capture time on them, but they're defending their B point with style.
Yeah, they do have the high ground right now. They've also got Ben just dancing with this soldier and spamming those pills at him. Cade didn't take a lot of damage from that, but what is... Oh, it's a hat. Okay, I thought I saw a head grab for a second there. I was like, wait, I'm not playing Half-Life. But Grimode here is now trying to poke with the rest of his team, or at least part of his team, scout going towards A, so it looks like most of them are going to get on A and try to capture it. They do have to do that quickly, because of course C is getting capped pretty quickly right now, but
but the soldiers dive bomb into C point, trying to protect that, however does not work out so hot for them. Pet having to back out, looks like he's going to make it just nice and safe.
Well, it did actually work out. That soldier, was that Cade, I think, that jumped in, or was it Dungeon? Either
it
way.
It was both.
Well, they had to stop that. If they didn't, they would have lost the round right there. So, you know, it was a sacrifice, but it was a good sacrifice to make. Now, of course, laser beams hold B and C once again. They've got time on A. They're getting back capped on C by probably a scout. And here we go. The Uber comes in trying to stop the cap on A. Nice.
It's all going to be about who gets the most DM here. And if anybody goes back to try to save C point from Boink's capture, it's only times two, but that's still going to be enough to capture it in time to prevent any A win here. It looks like they're going to try to stack A, but that's not going to work out, I don't think, here. I think C's capping just a little bit too quickly.
It's actually really close.
Really close.
Oh, C barely. That was half a second apart.
Barely. So now it's really up to the laser beams to protect B, and if they protect B and take a nice high ground advantage, it looks like they're going to be able to roll onto C fairly easily.
Yeah, they've got B. They were actually spawn camping right there, so there's not a lot of man to do about it.
All that they need here is one really good engagement, and it'll be really good for them. Looks like they're going to try to do this engagement by aggressing the enemy spawn. Pet making a bad decision to back out, not into his spawn, but into the B connector, and that's not a good spot to be as a medic against an entire enemy team. It looks like the entire cap's going to go here. I don't want to call that a really good engagement for Laser Beam so much as a bad out-of-position experience for Mayhem. The caller for Laser Beams just seemed to have known exactly where Mayhem was going to be and put that pressure down right there and made sure that nothing ever came out of their ability to resupply.
Yeah, that was a crazy good half for the Laser Beams. We're going to see, hopefully... All right, I'm just looking at this. Are you serious? 18-karat gold-plated mechanical keys. What? Okay. Well, anyway, I don't think I've ever needed gold on my keyboard, but I guess if you do, that's neat.
Well, do you know why they put gold on that?
No.
Gold has a better electrical conductivity. If you buy a Razer mouse, for instance, the connector, the USB connector, is gold. It's not actual solid gold. It's just gold plated with the thinnest layer possible of gold. They use I think it's called the electrostatic plating or something like that, or
yeah,
something.
Yeah, and I guess if you were talking about, you know, the distance from Houston to Dallas, that might matter in terms of like latency and whatever else. But
you can squeeze up to a couple milliseconds from doing that with gold as compared to more common materials, and it doesn't actually add all that much to the cost of the device. Although with the amount of gold they would need for a keyboard, that's maybe a little different.
I don't know. I'm going to remain skeptical on this one until I see it with my own eyes. But anyway,
hey man,
we do have the second half starting right now, and that is Laser Beams now in the red, Mayhem in the blue.
Oh,
Ben setting up a sticky trap.
Going down instantly.
What's up? Oh, Pet. Yeah, Pet's gone down already. That's actually a really good kill there. But where is Pure right now? He just got away with that.
Yeah, Pure just walked in, killed Pet, and then walked away, completely uncontested. Oh, it looks like they're going to try to stop A capture here, but it does not happen. Dungeon Defender and now Cade going to be taken out in quick succession here. So now A and C are both capped for laser beams, and we saw them do this the first round where they just capped the two outside points and then traded one of the outside points for B point. And that turned out to be a really good trade because then they had the high ground advantage on wherever the enemy team was. So let's see if they can continue making use of this strategy here.
Well, Pure and Zebrine both just died there trying to cap B, and that's going to be Mayhem holding onto it for a while. Now, which way do they decide to go, though? That's the problem. Whichever way they go, they're probably going to end up losing B. They could even leave a sticky trap, and it still wouldn't do enough. This is a very wide point. Right now, they're just kind of standing on B, actually, and they're leaving one scout to go to A. That's an interesting choice. If they hold on to B and they can just keep that one scout, they're actually capping it, it'll be good. They do seem to be sending the rest of their team through towards... I want to say this is towards A, but I'm probably totally wrong. No, that is towards A. All right.
Yeah, it is towards A. Well, here's the problem with what they've done here. They've given themselves the height and positional disadvantage by all going towards A, and they already have an uber disadvantage, so really, the laser beams are in a little bit of trouble here as Mayhem goes on to capture C.
Yeah, I did like the little play there from Pet, by the way. That was some good dodging from him. He did not pop that uber, even though he got down to 13 health. He knew where his enemy was. He knew he could get away from it. So there you go. C is capped right now. There goes the Uber. Gonna stop the point. Stop the capture at least temporarily on B. And Dr. Donut Man just got down to really low health too there before popping his Uber. Now gonna have to get away because as soon as that fades, if he's spammed at all, you're gonna die. But no, he doesn't. Pet still having some trouble here. He's at about 50 health right now, and he's got to be really careful about this scout on top of him. And there he goes. Dies to Z Brian. Do the cleanup.
Mayhem started out that engagement really, really nicely, but the Laser Beams team just kind of scattered a little bit, showed their invite experience, and then re-aggressed as soon as both Ubers were out, and that sort of... They had this health advantage towards the end of the fight that could not be matched by Mayhem. I think if we went back and looked at the demos, looked at the health, we'd see a big advantage in the Laser Beams side.
Oh yeah, and I... Laser Beams right now are doing some crazy DM too. Z-Brian's the only heavy hitter up right now. He's trying to get some damage there on Pet, and Pet actually does die. Oh, I'm sorry, I was looking at the wrong way around. But anyway, Laser Beams holding on to point A quite easily here. They've got to watch out for point B now, and what is Pure doing here? Pure, what are you doing?
I think what Laser Beams is going to do here is try to get themselves onto B, capture that point, kill off these players. Unfortunately, they had to pop the Uber. That's okay, because they're still going to have a decent ratio of who has what Uber.
Well, the thing is, right now, Mayhem's not capping anything, and they're not stopping the cap on C. So they may actually lose this round right away. They're going to have to stop it on C, and it might be too late.
Grimmon
barely get there in time.
There's an all-out frag fest, but that's not the kind of fight you want to engage with in this kind of position because they all got separated, got picked off one at a time. Laser Beam's taking it to 4-0, seemingly with ease. Mayhem, almost like I would consider them putting their foots in their mouths there at the end of that round. They looked on a decent footing. They looked like they were able to crawl through a comeback, and then they just threw it all the way by trying to defend A like that instead of with one designated push. Now we see here that the Mayhem team is going to go for B once again, and... I'm actually kind of liking the strategy here from Laser Beams to split up a little bit here.
They're not going to get the cap on A, and in fact, right now point B is getting a little bit pressured here, but Mayhem should get B just fine. And so they've done that. They will probably get A as well. If they even just leave one person back there and bring the rest of the team forward. Yeah, that's what they're doing right now. They're sending Boink over to finish off the cap on A, and then they're going to send the heavy hitters towards B to defend it. Although right now, B's actually getting capped. There you go. Oh, there's a Critz Krieg out from Mayhem.
And Grimmon.
Yeah.
Taking out Dr. Donut Man and Lang. Two very important. That's the combo, basically. So now B capture is going to be stopped, and only C is held onto right now by the Laser Beams.
There's some pretty sweet pipes there from Grimmon. It was not quite enough to save Pet there from the incoming Demo Man, though. And that's going to be Ben trying to get away here. He's almost certain to die. 7 health. How is Ben getting away from this right now? No, Mayhem. Abram Mellon finishes him off there. And, oh, there goes Pure as well. So, B may get capped, and C is in fact
I don't
already
think
capped.
So. Hmm. The Laser Beams team are two down, two important players, Pure and their Demo Man. So, I think that Mayhem might, yeah, they're splitting up here.
Mayhem have lost this. B is going to get capped here.
No, but A has not been capped. A has not been capped yet.
Okay, that makes sense.
A has yet to actually been capped, so they're not going to lose it here. Yeah, Pure.
What a confusing map. That's all I can say. But yeah, we do have right now coming from B. We have Laser Beams. They were trying to push their combo here. Now they're actually getting pressured pretty hard, so Mayhem is doing some good work. Cade is finished off by Ben, though. Good sticky trap there from Ben to finish him. Let me see. Where is Ben right now? He's on A. He's going to start laying some traps down on this wall here, which could defy anybody trying to come in and stop this cap. Now, can they stack this fast enough to stop it, though? Don't know about that. Grimmon ends up getting... not a lot of kills, but there you go, there's a forced Uber. C is now captured for Mayhem, so they're just barely keeping themselves in this game.
Yeah, Pet, almost at Uber. He's got to find somebody or just back up into spawn. This Uber is what might save them the round here, because the Laser Beams team does not have Uber, so meeting up with their players, getting these cap time down, and trying to force an engagement while they have Uber is what's really going to matter here. And taking out this medic, Dr. Donut Man does go down. That's an important pick here. Now it's this Demo Man. One more pick on the Mayhem team, and it's pretty much going to spell game over for them for the time being. B-Cap is going down. However, C needs to be stopped. They just need to get these ratios correct here, but the entire team for Mayhem is going to protect C. Looks like they don't want to take the risk, and they just want to defend their C-point, but that might be the wrong decision to make. Pet has gone down. Two scouts down right now for laser beams. 3v3 with one spawn each from each team. Grimmad going down to Pier. A lot of damage being done by Pier, actually. Two kills in a row there, and he's going to get on C-point. That might have been the winning move there from Pier, the winning play.
Yeah, it very well could, because right now Langa is even heading towards C. He's going to stack it up, and they're going to probably finish this off. That soldier just got completely trashed there. And with that cap, goes the game. So that's GG for the Laser Beams, 5-0 against Mayhem on quite a strange map, CP stand-in. But we've got more action for you guys, so don't go away.
Yeah, I think I'm getting my strategic bearings for this map. Such a interesting and
I'm not getting my camera bearings at all, man.
It's a map that has a lot of different, you know, fights breaking out at the same time, and so it's a lot of back and forth action. Some of my preconceived notions are a little wrong, but I think I really like this map, actually.
I'm trying to open my website, and there we go. So mobility versus Beybladers, huh?
Let's see if we can. STVM posted?
Yes.
Open. It hasn't even started yet. It's just warm up. Yeah. We should go to a commercial break.
We should. Too bad I'm not logged in. Go for it.
Neither am I. I don't know the password.
Nah. I know we had somebody logged in earlier who could totally do that for us. Wink, wink, nod, nod. You know what I mean? Nah, you're not going to do it. Anyway,
all right.
I got to say, I'm a big fan of weird gameplay. Although, right now, Gravel Pit is still my favorite for weird gameplay because it's quite easy to watch. It does look like X-Tine has taken care of our commercial break, so we will have one of those going on. Some people may see commercials, you know, in between.
Some people may not. Yeah, I don't think Gravel Pit really counts as a strange map anymore. In fact, I'd like to see more maps like Gravel Pit. I said this during Gravel Pit week, but I think that the format really lends itself well to spectating and even to a certain extent play. The problem is we haven't had a map that's as good as Gravel Pit yet. So the onus is really out there on the map makers to come up with something that is as fun and as competitive to play on as Gravel Pit. Because I love that map. I think it's just such an interesting map where all sorts of strategies can work. Such a strategic map while still having a lot of DM. And it's also a lot easier to follow the action because teams gear up for a push. You can tell when they're about to go for a push. There are these signifiers, and so you know where to put that camera on the action.
Yeah, it's a lot easier to follow. This action is just all over the place. It's tougher to follow. Yeah. I will say there is apparently an Easter egg that Kraka just told me about, so big shout-out to him. If you go above point C, down beneath the rockets a little bit, then you clip into the door, you'll see there's a door with some glass on it. There's a frog here, and there's a little poster, too. Kind of like it.
See, where here? Door with glass. Oh, yeah, I see it.
There you go.
Do I sound cool?
I hope I sound cool.
I don't even... Am I supposed to know who that is on that picture?
I don't know, man. I have no idea.
Well, that's Scorpio.
I almost feel like it would be good if I just had, like, preset camera positions, and instead of trying to follow players around, I could just click it and be like, oh, now they're on B. Click. Oh, now they're on C. You know, that would probably be better for this map.
Yeah, and Counter-Strike Source, has that capacity, but TF2 does not. Hint, hint, nudge, nudge, Gabe Newell. Except it's not really Gabe Newell's, you know, job, but whatever.
And we just got word from Kraka. He says, Mike to Shadow Puppet, don't dare talk about Tim. Not sure what that means.
Tim? Tim? Timothy? Tim? I don't know who Tim is.
I don't know, man. I honestly, I'm not into the joke either.
Ask Kraka what the hell he means.
Or no, Scorpio Uprising in chat right now is saying the same things.
That must be who the person is on that picture. Some guy named Tim.
Gotcha.
I guess I'm not cool enough for these TF2 in jokes.
No, I'm not cool enough either, and I think we already knew that. I am a huge nerd. But yes, Radio Raheem is apparently in the poster. So, Scorpio Uprising, thank you for the information, sir.
Yeah, big props to Scorpio Uprising. He's been working very hard to make maps that are good for competitive play, and I think that Stand-In is very good for competitive play. We just need to get our casting bearings on it, which is what this week will be very good for, in case this map is played in the finals for the ESEA invite. And, of course, for the playoffs for the rest of the leagues as well. So, you know, we're going to need to cast then, too, probably.
What I may do, instead of trying to follow players, I'll just, like, zoom my camera around third person the entire time. And if I clip through stuff, well, oh well. You know?
I do think we need to be able to set camera angles, though. That would help the action on this much better. You just press your button for B-point, and you'd be like, BAM! Look at all the action on B-point. Wait, there's a cap going on at C? BAM! Looking at the C-point. Yeah. That'd be awesome. So it looks like we've got, 10 players on the server right now? We're waiting for two more. We've got all six from Ability, and we are waiting for two from, what's their name? They changed their name.
It's Mobility versus Beybladers.
It's still Beybladers, okay. I'm getting confused by the You Must stuff.
Yeah, I think it's because they supposedly were naming it after You Must Recover.
An old school demo man of unprecedented caliber, but very high caliber demo man play. I haven't seen a whole lot of him this season. I wonder if he's still up to the same par he used to be, but an old name in TF2, if there ever was one.
Yeah, pretty sweet. But I don't think YMR is actually on their team, so we're not going to see him.
No, he is.
Is he? I still don't think we're going to see him.
He's the demo man.
Are you sure about that?
Well, I'm pretty sure.
Because
somebody
that he wasn't.
I'm about 99% sure he played in the match against my team earlier this season.
D-Select is their demo right now.
Well, he's playing demo in pregame.
The last time I casted these guys, D-Select was their demo.
Well, how about we ask the stream chat? I don't have it open, despite the fact of having a new giant monitor and my old monitor right next to me.
Well, you're just lazy.
I am. Here, let me alt-tab. I'll even go to the page now.
But yeah, stream chat, if you guys know whether YMR is actually going to be playing tonight, and we don't, then you are winners, and I will I'll give you a scrap or something. I don't know.
You get a shout on the stream.
Yeah, that's what you get. It's just as good as a scrap. It's not really. Oh, he's got a nice little combo going on here.
Dr. Haphazard asks why we can't bind keys to skip to a certain player. You actually can if you're spectating in the server. You can't be spectating from a relay or a source TV, because those are set up differently. It has to do with the way that the TF2 system initiates players in source TVs and demos. You cannot select players by number. However, if you're just spectating from a server, you can. So, little known fact, I guess. If you're just spectating, it's the weapon bind. You can go up to weapon bind 10, I think, and you can select any player 1 through 10 that way.
Yep. So that's kind of nice. Xtine pointing out that if you do that spec player command, I think that's Xtine. I don't think you can just bind it, though. I think you actually, at least according to, I think it was Tame who I was talking to, or maybe it was somebody else, Shrike, but you can actually run a config. You have to have a config preloaded that does those binds.
I think you're lagging out, Sal.
What's up?
You, like, cut out there, I think.
Oh.
Or is that just me?
It's probably my push-to-talkie.
Oh.
My bad. But yeah, Xtine knows what he's talking about here. So, yes, it's possible, but it's also a heck of a lot of work, so...
Well, maybe Valve should just implement the same features that Counter-Strike Source gets, and everything will be fine and dandy.
Maybe they should.
Looks like we have 12 players now in the server.
Is one just of them not You Must Recover? Pretty sure, because Deselect is not You Must Recover.
Kraka, Scout, Sigma, Deselect, Sephi, Seymour. I don't know, ask Kraka. If one of them is Weimar. And... I could ask Sigma, but that would require shift-tabbing.
WapWapWat's actually telling me that Deselect did play demo for their last match. Weimar is paid for on their team, but he isn't playing today.
I guess we're both right. Except you're slightly more right than me.
Possibly. So hopefully we do see the double sniper play out of Team Beybladers. You know, double sniper, maybe one heavy, one spy. No medic. They shouldn't have a medic.
I think it would be heresy to not run Sigma on medic. I think that would be... I would cry.
I think you should definitely run sniper instead of medic. And then they need a pyro. Just in case the enemy team has a spy. I mean, you wouldn't want to like die to a spy, right?
I think he should run quick fix medic. What is your beef with the quick fix, man?
Oh, I don't know. You're right. It's like the best weapon. My bad.
But no, it's actually awful. I don't know. I want to see somebody run it, at least for one thing, and I can't think of a better map to do it on than this one.
I have seen it used on Viaduct. In fact, I casted a game with it with Deuter on Viaduct.
Interesting.
It was not used the whole time, and whenever it was used, no. It was completely unsuccessful. But it does look like we are seeing GLHF in the chat, and so we're going to go live very soon. This is, of course, Salamancer. I'm joined by Dr. Shadow Puppet. We're casting Mobility Gaming versus the Beybladers on CP Stand-In, a brand spanking new map.
Match is live here. I'm on the Kapow Cam, watching him put some stickies through the AB connector here, trying to get some spam down on the enemy combo before they can come up. However, the Beybladers taking a commanding position here, trying to get some spam down. They got a soldier on the roof, spamming down, and their demo man is walking across the point. Looks like there is an A-cap going on, and You Must Scout gets taken out, but Deselect and Seymour take out two in response. Looking good for the Beybladers here as they go on to cap the B-point. Let's see what kind of awesome strategy Sigma has come up with for this map.
Yeah, that'll be interesting to see. I'm watching, it looks like he and Rando... right now, or is that him and Rando? That's Zachiril, I'm sorry, and Rando for Mobility Gaming are watching the AB connector right now. They did just finish the cap on A. Nobody's even touched C yet. It's all A and B right now, so very different from last game. Scout trying to come in, he did! Kraka killed Zachiril there. That is going to be huge, because I think that guy actually just dropped an Uber.
Ooh, Zachiril, a very experienced medic, but you know, everybody makes mistakes at some point in time. Sigma not dropping that Uber, popping it, not dropping it, as his A-cap goes on. It looks like they're going to try to do a little action here on C with their heavy classes. Going to get on that point and try and cap it up here as their A-point is capped up rather nicely. Looks like nobody's going to try to go to defend the A-point. And instead, there's going to be an all-out battle for C. Whoever wins this battle is probably going to win the round. It looks like the Mobility Gaming team has to back out here, giving the Beybladers an opportunity to cap the point. BT taking out Kraka, and a scout getting on Sigma gets taken out by a nice pipe from You Must Deselect. Yeah, however, Sigma does go down to Kapow.
That was actually really clutch there, because I do believe Mobility Gaming is sending a soldier in at the medic with his equalizer in hand. But problem is, right now, Mobility actually got enough respawn players to start defending C properly. Spanker here getting taken out by Kraka, though. Sigma is just now back up. Deselect spamming pipes over here. It's just going crazy right now on C point.
Yeah, here's the thing. Neither team has actually capped C point yet, and the Beybladers are looking to set themselves up back on A, cap that point, and do the same thing we saw Laser Beams do last time, and hold the high ground above C, waiting for their opportunity to push in. Zackril has Uber to Sigma's 40%. It's one of the weird things about this map is that Uber advantages get really whacked out, but we will see what Mobility Gaming can do here, because I have to say, there's a backup on A. That's what I was going to say.
Oh yeah, Mobility's kept that up. Zackril did just have to pop his Uber against that Scout there, who may have actually just been Scout. No, I think that was, it was Scout. Krakow was somewhere else. There goes Zackril, though. Seymour found him walking towards point B, and right now Mobility holds 2 points to Team Beybladers 1. Beybladers only hold point B. Not the world's most easily defensible point, but you can do it, and Mobility is having some difficulty right now getting out there.
I'm liking the mobility I'm seeing from the Beyblader soldiers here. They're jumping all around the map together, working almost like a scout combo, taking advantage of the fact that rocket jumps are relatively easy on this map, and that there's lots of health packs strewn about the place to make it sure that they can stay full health. And as I say it, here comes the soldiers onto midpoint, followed by their medic. BT gonna back out, try to get some health here from his medic. C point has just been captured by the Beybladers as they continue their gambit for the B point. B point is still theirs, and it's up to them to defend it here as Sigma is rounding out 70% Uber while Zackril just died.
Yeah, now Mobility, here's the thing, they've got 3 players left, they're trying to just edge onto B and get that cap. A is in danger right now, and there you go, a scout did get onto it. Rando trying to spam in there, but it looks like if A is capped, of course, and if it's capped quickly, the Beybladers will end up with a round win. Right now, though, they're actually at Mobility is getting somebody onto point C at the moment. Oh man, this is kind of scary, though. Beybladers going in for the medic. Do not manage to get that kill on Zackril, but he's at 30 health right now. Gotta be really careful about that.
Yes, very careful indeed. Both scouts currently down for Mobility Gaming, and that's what's kind of been keeping them alive so far this match, is those scout backcaps, because the combo from Beyblader is just way too strong for the Mobility team to deal with. Beachy getting taken out by a clutch shotgun. Sigma considering popping a Zuber in here through A to try to help assist on that cap, and it looks like he's gearing up to do so as this Demoman tries to deny him entrance. His soldiers seem to do work all on their own, though. Sigma just hanging onto this Uber for dear life. Very nicely played from Sigma there.
Yeah, and point A just about to finish up here. Mobility Gaming trying to get onto point B now, but yeah, they're going to get spammed really fast by a team that's on the warpath. The Beybladers are now pushing through point C. They've got to be careful. Is there a sticky trap? No, there's not. They can get through this choke unimpeded, and that's exactly what they're doing. They're going to stack up here. They've got an Uber. They can almost assuredly get this point. The only question is whether Mobility is actually going to get a back cap going on. There you go. They've already lost two players.
They look like they're not even going to try to. Oh, one scout's down, and the other scout's actually over here on C point. Zackril going down. Only two up right now. Spanker and Kapow are both trying to defend C, but it's not going to work out. Oh, some great positioning from the Beybladers team, some excellent decision-making from their caller Sigma, allowed them to take that first round after a much longer time than we saw our last match take per round. Very nice back-and-forth play there. The scouts from Mobility Gaming just not able to quite do it for them. The combo from the Beybladers is too strong. I'm on the deselect cam as he spams over onto the A side of B. That's kind of a tongue twister there. Trying to sticky off that soldier from getting onto his medic. Spanker has already gone down, but so has a scout for the blue team, who's actually named Scout.
Yeah, it's confusing as all hell. But Mobility Gaming are probably going to lose this fight over B. They do have a scout. I think a scout is going to be Moranis, probably on
Moranis.
Point A. And nobody's, once again, touched point C yet. So it's all about A and B right now. And Beybladers very decisively do win the fight on point B.
Yeah, Sigma is a medic and a caller who likes to position his team in the height advantage, in the position advantage, and able to get his team a lot of heals, so it's no surprise to me that he is having his team contend B so heavily here, because as they cap B, they're in a commanding position to take either point if they need to at a moment's notice. They are, however, going to need to make a move onto C as soon as they deal with these players here respawning. Zackril pops his Uber, but so does Sigma, and there's going to be an Uber fight here. Demoman on the point, trying to spam out.
Wow. Good Uber flashing there by Zacril, making sure his soldiers stay alive for as long as possible. Seffi and Kraka both just died there, so it's only one scout, one soldier for that team, and their demo and medic are up as well. You know, the Beybladers are trying to get a cap down on point C right now, but there goes Sigma. He did manage
after
to kill Rando.
Rando.
Yeah.
So nicely done by Sigma there. I always like to see those medic kills, but Zacril is going to have that 65 or so percent Uber advantage before Sigma meets up with his team. Maybe even more, 70 to 75, depending on how long it takes him. And the Mobility Gaming team isn't looking too bad here. They have A. They might be able to make a move on for B here. If they cap B, I give their chances of winning this round very, very high percentages.
Yeah, right now they do have to deal with soldiers on the high ground, though. Beybladers manage to force Zacril to drop
goes
the Uber.
Down. That's the second drop this game, isn't it?
It is.
Wow.
It's a weird map. Sometimes you caught unprepared thinking about stuff that you don't normally think about, you know? Sometimes it's like, wait, suddenly I get this warm feeling when I think about girls, and all of a sudden you're dropping Ubers left and right. So, yeah, you gotta be pretty careful. Now, the Beybladers do hold on to B, but they're losing C at the moment, and there is pretty much no way they can stop that. But on the other hand, they could get a couple kills here going towards A, and they will probably get the cap.
Yeah, I would like to see them try to cap this A point here and then hold on to B and be in a very commanding position. Sigma has about a 20 to 30% Uber advantage here. That's about 20%. And so having that Uber advantage and forcing a fight on their terms, which is something that Sigma is very good at leading his team into doing, will be very important here. They're going to need to catch the Zacril before he gets Uber, and they need to go right now onto B point. Here comes the pop in from Sigma onto his soldier. Gonna try to find Zacril. Zacril is way far away though, and it looks like the Beyblader is just gonna be content with capping the point. Zacril getting very dangerously close to Uber. It's all gonna be about how many kills Beybladers can get before this Uber is popped. Here it comes in. The answer is going to be 3 kills. Let's just see if that's going to be enough here as the Beybladers team scatters out.
Now, the thing is, Mobility is going to get enough respawns here that they will be able to cap B very easily, but at the same time, there goes their medic. And yeah, Ubers are okay for this, but it's starting to look like, really, getting player advantages and kill advantages, it just doesn't matter that much, even, because, you know, if you're capping a point, it takes forever to do that anyway. You kind of need all your players to be on one point, and you're always open to a back cap. It's absolutely crazy.
Yeah, I mean, I in a lot of ways I agree, but in a lot of other ways I don't. And see, here's a huge problem. The Mobility Gaming team is splitting up their players, and they're not going to be able to stop the cap in time. If they had just stacked everybody on B, that might have not happened. But instead, the Beybladers come out here, and actually, I really disagree with your analysis of how the advantages aren't important, because we see that the Beybladers are really playing off these advantages, and it's working for them enough of the time that it's giving them these two last rounds. We're seeing a calm, patient, methodical style from Sigma and his team that I like quite a bit on this map.
Well, we'll see whether that matters, because I gotta say, it seems like sometimes a team will get a bunch of picks and then fail to cap a point anyway, so I'm a little confused by that. But Mobility Gaming is, there you go, BT gets a kill on Seffi, Rando kills Scout, getting back to the medic now, making sure he doesn't die right away. And Crack is down as well, so the Beybladers are definitely losing a lot of players here. Mobility, they need to start capping B, because they are just now capping A. There you go, Scout finished that off.
Yeah, I think that the Beybladers team didn't get quite aggressive enough. They didn't deny that soldier from the AB connector like they had been in the last couple rounds, and it worked out really well for Mobility Gaming there. However, Sigma is leading his team into a great position here, picking off both BT and Spanker before these Ubers go off. And it's all about those initial picks before the Uber fight. You know, that's such a very important topic in this game. And it looks like the Beybladers team is going to have no problem capping B point here, getting their players on, and trapping the enemy team at C. However, they are going to be kind of surrounded here by the fact that it looks like the Mobility Gaming team is going to be able to get both A and C here.
Well, Mobility will get C, but the thing is, they did just lose a couple players.
Three down.
Yeah, they're not feeling like they're really going to be solid on that right now. And actually, C was just barely stopped on the capture there. Mobility not even getting that one yet. Right now, it's getting reverted very quickly. Or at least it was. There must have been somebody on point C, but right now we're watching Seymour peek his head out of spawn, pretty much. No, that's not spawn, I'm sorry. That is the BC connector. And he's looking at that scout. Doesn't manage to hit that. So right now, I just have no idea what's going on anymore, but I'm going to keep talking like I do. The Uber is popped here for Zacril. probably a force. Pretty much that seems to be most of the Ubers on this map, because the teams do not have especially coordinated strategies right now. C's getting capped. Mobility looks like in a position to potentially capture B, but they've got to worry about getting bombed in right now. There's only, I think, one scout on A, so we're going to see the Beybladers come in and try to stop this cap on B.
Yeah, they absolutely have to stop this cap right now. Sigma can't even wait for Uber.
Oh,
very nice rocket work there and demo work. Taking out Zachro and Rando is really big here. A is going to be captured, and B is going to be... B hasn't even been captured yet, has it?
Well, it looked like maybe Moranis was going to get it there, and then it ended up not happening. So, the Beybladers are probably going to revert B. But no, I think B has already been captured. It is in the favor of the Beybladers. So they really just have to cap C, and that's what they're going to go do. They need to leave one person on B right now to stop the cap there. But if they can be quick enough about this, I think they can get it. Now it's getting stacked on B. So no, Mobility Gaming will have B. And there you go. Sephi is down right now. I'm wondering if Mobility can stop A. They'll have this. They've just gotten 3 kills so far. They need to get in there.
Oh, so very close there. C gets taken by the Beybladers team, and I don't even know what to think here. There's just so much disjointedness. I think Sigma needs to pull this team together a little bit here. I thought that was round.
No, they don't have C yet. The thing is, Mobility lost C, and they have to reclaim it. Crazy action right now. Zachro just got taken out by Scout. Scout in turn killed by Rando, and the Uber is popped here for the Beybladers. It just finished off, and now Rando just jumped into like 4 players there. He got 1 kill, and then there goes Sephi and Sigma. Miranda's getting a good cleanup. Sigma's down. D-Select is down as well. I think Mobility Gaming has this round.
Oh, I think that's it. I think that's it. I think it's going to be 2-1 Mobility Gaming here as they finish up this cap on C point. Unless some players from the Beybladers can go absolutely crazy, but it doesn't look like it's going to happen here.
Nope. Actually, good work's not good enough. So it is now 2-1 Beybladers versus Mobility Gaming.
Yeah. I think the Beybladers really saw their strategy picked apart there, where they just could not regroup and make those giant, those well thought out planned pushes that Sigma is so used to calling out here. Let's see if the Beybladers team can rally up another victory here and take the half. Sigma being kind of left alone to his own devices, having to pull out that needle gun, deselect, going down. That's an early demo pick for the Mobility Gaming team, who are looking quite strong here going into the fourth round.
And Spanker here just helping to capture B right now. Mobility actually is capping A and B at the same time. C now getting capped because it looks like the Beybladers have realized we can't really do a lot about this right now. So point B here could be captured. It's possible. Thing is, now there's a couple of soldiers and scout trying to stop this, but no, there you go. Demo and scout are probably going to finish this off. So A and B are both in the hands of Mobility Gaming right now. Point C has not been captured. It is still neutral. And it looks like the Beybladers are just going to waltz over towards point B and not even care about C at the moment.
Yeah, C's not even being finished capping here by the Beybladers team. I think if Beybladers cap B here, it'll be very, very good for them. I wish I could see how much time's left in the half. I can't tell if it's been the half an hour yet or not. This is the action's
no,
been so back
and
forth.
No, it's about 14 minutes left. It's just crazy action all over the place.
Wow.
Mobility Gaming here are trying to cap C. Here comes an Uber, though, so that's pretty much just going to say no to that. And so the Beybladers will probably get on point C. They may end up losing point B. They'll probably keep a couple heavy classes out there on B, but gotta watch out.
Yeah, but here's the thing, though. Sigma got forced into that pop, and if there's one thing that I think is true about this map is that forcing a pop means that it's not going to be converted into useful energy here. However, the cleanup is going to be enormous here as frags just come left and right for the Beybladers team. Only 3 up currently for Mobility Gaming. If the Beybladers can find Zachril and kill him before he gets his Uber, it'll be huge, but it looks like Zachril's just going to back up into spawn, riding that pill into the spawn cabinet, gonna build up this Uber and then try to take on the Beybladers team directly. The Beybladers only need to cap A
stopping the cap on C right now, but in turn they have had their capture on A stop. Let's go find out what's happening over there. Fat lot of nothing.
Actually, is C neutral? C is neutral. Yeah, C needs to be captured. this map. My HUD doesn't show the colors very nicely, so, yeah. But Scout taking out Spanker there, one down as the Uber comes in from both teams. Sigma going to lose his Uber a few seconds before Zackroll and is going to back on out accordingly, baiting that soldier in. Nicely done by Sefi. He's going to try to go for Zackroll. Can't get him, Kapow with a nice pan kill.
Yeah, so now Mobility down two players are losing point C, and all they have to lose it now is point A. Well, so far, actually, C is still just barely not in the hands of the Beybladers, and there you go, it's going to get reverted very quickly by these two scouts from Mobility. So I am just going to put my foot in my mouth for the rest of the night.
That's one of the things about this map, is that a cap can just stop instantaneously because of the limited sight lines between points here. BT, a confusing move. D-Select wasn't even lit there as he bombed in, but you know, whatever floats his boat. It looks like the Beybladers team is going to try to make a C defense. This is one of the first times I've actually seen them try to put up a solid defense here. Here comes the Uber right as Zackroll gets his Uber. Kind of poor timing, but Sigma didn't really have a choice in popping there. Now that you see the Beybladers team is just going to split up and wait to re-aggress here. And here comes the re-aggression onto the C point by the enemy, by the Blue Soldier. Both Blue Soldiers here bombing onto the point. Great re-aggression from the Beybladers team. Cleans up almost the entire Mobility Gaming team. I think only one person survived that fight, and that is Spanker.
Yeah, so
he's going back in.
They need to really stop A. That's what their decision has to be right now, because they're not going to stop C. There's too much in there. There's an uber advantage for the Beybladers, so it looks like they have done what they need to do and stopped A. Kraka does find Moranis.
Kraka! Oh, but can't take out Spanker. That's unfortunate, but you know what? There'll be another opportunity here, because the Beybladers have B and C and are in a position they love to be in.
Oh, I just... What? Well, apparently you can put a sticky... Wow, that is sneaky, sneaky, sneaky. You can put sticky traps here in the A-B connector, like in between those pipes. Oh, man.
Oh, that's a nice spot, actually. Seymour's going to be able to... not Seymour. Kapow's going to be able to do a lot of denial there. But the bomb is on the side. That's kind of what needs to happen.
Yeah, not a bad pop here from the Beybladers. They've gotten two kills so far. Zackroll is down.
It's all about this cleanup.
It's 3v3 here. Moranis trying to get the cap on C, and he may end up getting a good amount of time there, but there will be respawners to stop him.
Sigma takes out BT. Sigma needs to find health packs. I think he needs to go for this health pack. He needs to risk it.
Well, at this point, he's just going to keep his soldiers alive, trying to cap A faster than C gets capped. We'll see whether that actually happens, though. No, they're having to drop back away from it, and they are not stopping the scout from capping C. So, it'll be a nice long round for us here. Mobility will get C captured, and they still hold
it. Wow. Yeah, that A defense was very good by Mobility Gaming. If one more player from the Beybladers team had stayed alive after that fight, it would have been over for that round. But as it is, the Beybladers team is capping that A point. Sigma goes down, however. That's a pretty big blow here. Because Zachary's going to have maybe a 10 to 15% Uber advantage, even though we've been noticing that Uber advantages like that don't really tend to be all that important on this map, because kiting is so easy.
Yeah, it really is. And Mobility now is... I would almost like to see a lot more Blitzkrieging coming in from these teams, because... like you said, kiting's easy, but it's much harder when you get a crit sticky in your face.
Well, that's the thing, though. You know, because these scouts are able to get around, they can see that the medic has that crit screen, and then the enemy team can just position themselves, so kiting is super, super easy. And I think the crit screen has very limited utility on this map to only the most extreme of surprise plays.
Yeah, well, okay.
And maybe mid-fight.
Alright. That's fair. It's worked out a couple times in our last game, so I would like to see how it worked in this one. Zackroll did just pop Uber, and actually
way before
Spanker.
But Sigma drops his Uber to an Ubered scout. Oh, uncharacteristic of Sigma. His entire team falling apart. Mobility Game is going to really need to take advantage of the fact that they just killed a lot of players, get some cap time on some points. They need to leave C point right now and start capping other points. This can be their only opportunity here to really take a dominating position. And here they go, right onto the midpoint, just in time to meet the blue team as they're coming out of spawn. Crack goes down, saving the rest of his team, however, and Zackroll does get taken out. giving Sigma about a 50% advantage, which is actually significant on this map.
Yeah, and there you go. There is a capture on A right now. It's going to be a race between A and B, leaving one scout on B here, and everybody else from Beybladers is trying to stop the cap on A. Looks like they're successful so far. If they can just keep that scout capping B, they will be okay for a while yet. There goes a couple of players here from the Mobility Gaming team. Although Beyblade is losing a soldier of their own, yeah, Mobility's not going to have this.
No, absolutely not. Only two players up for Mobility Gaming, and BT and Moranis joining their fight right now. Scout has to back up from B point, but it's only a matter of time for the rest of the Beybladers team comes into mid here. Both scouts, and here comes the demo man onto B point. Oh, pop from Sigma. I think he's a little shaken up by that drop and wanting to not take those risks again here. B point is captured, and A point is getting a back cap on it. We'll see if the Beybladers team just goes for an engagement here on C.
I don't know.
Times seven, man. It's gonna be pretty damn close here, I think.
Well, it's...
No, not with that times two. It's not gonna happen.
Nope, so there you go. Yep. A is gonna get capped by Mobility. They may lose C, although at this point they're still holding on to it, and the Beybladers team is running their medic and demo back to spawn, where they're gonna build up an Uber for a bit, and we'll see which way they decide to go. Looks like towards B.
Yeah, they have to defend B, because if B is captured, then Mobility Gaming team wins the round, taking it 2-2, which is a position I don't think Sigma was ready to put his team in after winning those first two rounds.
Never fun to lose a big advantage like that in points. There goes Sigma, actually, and D-Select now taken down as well. So it's 3-3 here, Mobility standing on point B. They are still being stopped by this soldier, but there goes Seymour. Zacharyl with 75% Uber now.
Yeah, so long as they stop this A point from being captured for just a little bit of time here, Rando trying to come in here, leaving his medic, instead going for the scout. Well, his medic actually comes with him, I didn't see that. So they decide to defend A instead of trying to cap B.
That's actually really scary. Just, well, they still hold C. No, never mind.
Yeah. If they hadn't had C, then yeah, that would have been the only appropriate choice. Scout's going to try to come back in here for the A point once again. Looks like he's going to be able to wrap it up rather nicely here before the B point gets captured. A huge fight on B point here as BT goes down, taking D-Select and Scout, though, is a pretty big deal for Mobility Gaming here. Even Ubers, even players down. Let's see if the combo from the Beybladers can actually do something on the B point here.
It looks as if they are going to hold on to it for a while. Seffy's taking a lot of hits, but he does keep getting those crucial heals, using a lot of good cover. Now they're getting flanked a little bit by a soldier here, but oh, missing almost every rocket on Seffy, and Seffy in return dealing a lot of damage to him. I think it was BT, who is now down to about 100 health. Now down to less than 100, gotta be careful.
Yes, gotta be careful indeed. Both medics with 100% Uber here. It's gonna be a vie for position for whenever this fight goes on. Both medics have to know that a fight's about to break out. It's all about making sure that the team is in appropriate position to make sure they don't lose the game with this one fight. Oh, Zacharyl has to pop, gets forced. That's not a good position to be in here because Sigma has the Uber. He can just lead his team in here to defend this B point. Both A and B are dangerously close to being capped, but of course, as we know, there is no overtime on this map.
Yeah, right now the Beybladers getting the better of their opponents in the DM, but look at how short these respawn times are, actually. BT died not very long ago, and is going to be back up in like 5 seconds. So there you go, he's already up now. Mobility are getting the cap on A and B at the same time, but it's not really working too terribly well for them.
If they get both these caps, then, you know,
there's a combo on A stopping them. Spanker doing his best to try and deal some damage. Sigma down to about 50 health. And now the combo from Mobility is heading out to finish that cap off on A. Actually, that's
they're going to get it. And they do. Mobility takes it to 2-2. Oh, man. That's a huge blow to the momentum from the Beybladers team here. Mobility having this momentum going into the very final round of the half. Let's see if they can do something with it. I want to see the same performance we've been seeing out of them so far. The Beybladers, I want to see a lot of aggression.
Yeah, Kapow putting down some good sticks underneath the soldiers right now, and a beautiful air pipe from Kapow finishes off Seymour. Sadly, the rest of the Mobility Gaming team not faring quite as well. It's just Moranis left alive.
We saw the power of an effective Demoman there as D-Select came in and take out Zacharyl, Rando, and I believe Kapow with, within the space of like 2 or 3 seconds. Very nicely played by him. B-Point is going to go to the Blue Team Beybladers, and C-Point looks like it might as well as Kraka tries to pick up that cap.
D-Select was down to 6 health there. Managed to back away. Meanwhile, Seymour was up on the high ground for a little bit, but has decided that he just wants to go with the rest of his team now towards Point C, and they're probably going to... I thought they were going to stack it up, but it looks like they were just trying to make sure there wasn't really a move by Mobility Gaming to get there.
Here comes the Uber! Oh, this is such a terrible position for the Mobility Gaming team. The Beybladers looking in fine position once again. Zacharyl, however, going to get out with this huge advantage, and it's going to be up to the Beybladers to put themselves in a good position to absorb the effects of this Uber so that they can transition into winning the round by capping A point. Looks like they're going to try to force the engagement on A, which is not necessarily the worst of options here.
No, there's an Uber from Mobility, so they're going to hold on to it for a little bit, but actually really good play by Sigma, who just said, I know they have an Uber, I know they're going to at me. Yeah.
And now all this is going to take is a really good re-aggress, which is something the Beybladers are known for, is the really, really good re-aggression. Seymour taking out Zacharyl, that's huge. Rando picks him up, but that medic for a soldier, very, very good trade-off.
Yeah, well, right now, Point C was just barely stopped there, I think, by Scout taking out Moranis. Point B is now getting captured by Mobility, but they're losing players, they're bleeding out right now. And even though they hold A, I could very easily see somebody getting out there for back cap and Mobility not able to cap either B or C.
Yeah, it looks like the Beybladers are going to try to defend a little bit here and then make one solid push in. Both soldiers currently down for Mobility Gaming. Scout on the C back cap is going to put a wrench in the plans of the Beybladers, but A point looks like it might be theirs.
It should be. Zacharyl just died again. And, oh, now Zephy
and Deselect. Zephy and Deselect. Oh, now the Beybladers team's in a bad position that they're not going to be able to get out of very easily here. Sigma looks like, oh, he's got a scout step. I mean, Sigma is very comfortable playing with his scouts as his combo. Very familiar with that situation and knows how to play it out very appropriately. And appropriately, he does play it out, not getting too aggressive with these scouts, but knowing their abilities. Zephy comes in, takes out Spanker, and is met up with his medic. I like the position here from the Beybladers.
Yeah, it's not too bad. And there you go. Time is over. So good half.
Ooh,
2-2.
A tie for the half. Beybladers carried it up to an early lead 2-0, but Mobility Gaming rallying it up in those last two rounds with some aggressive play that the Beybladers team could not deal with effectively.
Yeah, that was a pretty sick half, I'm not going to lie. And I would expect our next half to last another half hour as well, guys. So do be ready to watch a lot of TF2.
I certainly hope not. I have to get up in 5 hours for work.
Yeah, you know, I've got work too, but yeah, I don't have early meetings, so at least I can go in like an hour late. That'll be what I'll do.
Maybe I'll call in late to work. That might be a good idea. No, that's not a good idea. I'm just kidding. Don't do that, kids.
It's a great idea. Don't go to work, guys. TF2 is better. Look at this scout, man. That is... That's an outfit right there. It's an outfit. Alright. Sorry, TF2 fashion. It's pretty cool. Kapow actually wearing the same hat that I do, so I gotta give props to that guy. I wonder if he has a medal right now. Do you have a medal?
It's a very, very good hat. He does.
It's a Team Fortress 2 medal. I don't even know what that is, but I gotta say it looks pretty sweet. And then his bombs are not normal bombs either. I don't know how to get those, but those look pretty awesome. Are you seeing this? Are you seeing Kapow right now? Look at those bombs.
I am. Somebody in chat needs to tell us how to get these things.
Yeah, I have no idea what those are, but I wish I did. Alright, well, it looks like we had a couple players relaunching TF2 there. So we gotta wait a little bit for this half to restart. But we'll see what happens. Effel is saying they are pirate bombs. But that doesn't help me too much. I guess you have to...
How do you get them? How do you get them?
I don't know.
Halloween update?
I don't know. Okay, so maybe it is a Halloween update. Yeah, it makes sense. They go with the peg leg set. Gotcha. I'm gonna look at this now. I just got linked to the wiki, so. Good night, guys. I'm not gonna cast anymore because now I'm gonna be on the wiki all night.
Wait, you're leaving me?
Yep.
For real?
The camera will still be
running.
I'm
kidding, okay.
You know.
So, who are we waiting for here? Oh, Rando. Okay.
Yeah, definitely a sweet-looking pirate set, actually. The Scottish handshake, the Buccaneers bicorn, a whiff of the old brimstone, as those bombs are called, and the bootlegger. I like it. And somebody just said LinkedIn TV. You know, a lot of people say TV tropes is really, really addictive. I have never found it to be that way. I'll check like three articles and I'm like, okay, I'm done. So
yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
I'm much more susceptible to cute pictures of puppies. I'm a dog guy.
I like my dogs, but I think what I'm susceptible to is more like flash games when I'm playing, you know, at work and I'm supposed to be you know. Don't tell them.
So I'd like to take this opportunity to thank everybody who's tuning in to watch our stream. Even though you don't really have much of a choice in North American TF2 coverage, we thank you for choosing EXTV as your portal of choice.
Yeah, I mean, we are always dedicated to bringing you guys free TF2 streaming content whenever we possibly can, and with ESEA basically being every night, that's pretty much every night.
Every night that we can get people. Of course, EXTV is always looking for talented and dedicated staff members who are looking to expand their horizons into the esports scene, help out esports, help out TF2, and do something fun and rewarding along the way. There are tons of perks to working as an EXTV staff member, including, you know, camaradership. We have people stationed all the way across the globe. You'll meet us at LANs and things like that, and it's just a lot of fun working for us. So head over to extelevision.com, and I think there's like a recruiting link on the front page. I don't know. I don't check the front page very frequently. I'm more of a forum kind of guy, so. But
yeah, but I know that we need, you know, we're always looking for good video editors. I think that we are looking for people to help schedule stuff and be, you know, wranglers, essentially. What's up?
People with good community contacts, with lots of contacts on teams and communities, and have a deep understanding of especially leagues like Open, are more than welcome, because our coverage there can be helped a lot. Also, people who are capable of streaming video of the, we stream at 1280x720, correct?
Normally, although Deuter can actually stream at a higher level, he can stream
1080. Yeah, Deuter's EPing's fake, we know. So, people who can stream at least 1280x720, you know, at a decent frame rate, and, you know, so that requires a decent computer, and I think it's a 4 megabit upload per second?
I have 3.5, and that just barely squeaks it out.
Yeah. Alright, so if you have 3.5 to 4-ish, 4 would be preferable, but just hit us up, because we're always looking for more streamers. We only have a couple, you know, a handful of people who are capable of streaming, and I know Xsine has been talking a lot lately about expanding to the other two channels we have, EXTV Sports 2 and 3, to try to get some simulcasting going on, where, you know, there might be an open match conflicting with an invite match, and we want to cover both of them. We don't have the staff to do that now, but we certainly want to. So the second half is starting, so my spiel is over.
Yeah, I'm watching B right now to see whether there's actually going to be a B fight, and it looks like there will be. Both teams kind of settling in towards this, towards the A side, I guess, of B.
It's an easy demo spammer here for Deselect.
Yeah, although nobody's died yet. BT very close. This soldier up here taking some hits, but yeah, the high ground is held right now by the Beybladers, and it's showing. They're dealing some good damage and not having a lot of it returned on them. Kapow and now Spanker have both gone down, so point B is going to get capped, I think, by the Beybladers. Meanwhile, everybody from Mobility is back off to point A.
Yeah, good move, I think, by Zachril. He's going to be fairly safe here. Giving up that B point isn't that huge of a loss, because they've shown they can contest that easily. It's really going to be up to whether or not the Beybladers can cap C successfully without having to give up their position on B. That's what's really going to be important here, because their position on B is important to keeping them alive in this round here.
No, they've definitely given up B. I don't even see them out here right now. Scout just got taken down, and no, pretty much everybody from Beybladers is on C, and they haven't capped it.
No, it looks like they're going to go back, and oh, Sigma dropping into a nice sticky trap by Kapow. That's going to be huge here as Zacko pops his Uber. 2 down currently for the Beybladers team. Oh, it's looking fairly dire for the Beybladers. Oh, 3 down.
Well, they've dealt some good damage here. They did take out Kapow from Mobility at the very least, and now Deselect could actually get a good pipe or two off there. Oh, kind of missed that one. And now Scout's down, Deselect's down. Wow, Mobility looking good here. They are going to get B, I'm pretty sure, and they've got somebody on C right now, so they are very, very solid.
Yeah, Seffy trying to delay the B cap as long as he can. Good move by him, but I think they're fighting a losing battle here. 1 down for the Beybladers. Of course, that is Seffy. Oh, and the C cap is almost done. It's going to be up to the Beybladers to rush in here and try to cap it. It's up to this defense right here. Sigma going down. 3 down, 4 down. Oh, I think that's it. Quick round for Mobility Gaming, who from an early loss on B, come back and swing both of the other caps in their direction immediately. Just a terrible choice in positioning, I think, from the Beybladers team, allowed the Mobility Gaming team to do that. It is 3-2 Mobility Gaming heading into the 6th round.
Kapow going for some good spam here. Does take out Deselect right away as soon as he spots him in a bad position. Seffy just took a lot of damage there, and now Scout down. I think we are going to see Mobility winning this fight. They've just got to stop this cap on B. They've already got somebody on A as well. It's a Scout who's run off to A here. It's going to make it a little bit tougher for them to get the damage out on their opponents, but it gives them a cap.
Yeah, that's that cleanup power is completely gone, but the A point is there. Now that first cap is kind of a momentum swing in their favor here. B, I think B actually takes longer to cap. I'm not sure about that. Scorpio will have to inform us.
I have no idea, man, but I do know that Mobility is stopping the cap on B just barely. And now
they pop their Uber to do it, and Sigma has his Uber coming in here with a soldier, waiting to pop for as long as he can. It looks like he wants to go for an engagement. Or actually, no, he just wants to hold on to this Uber and then go for C-point here. He might decide to engage here.
They should, because it looks like Mobility only has 2 players left alive. Now 1, it's just Kapow. Let's see if he can't spoil them on A. Probably not, though. No, he's still in his spawn.
Yeah, I think he's just going to join up with this team instead of getting himself picked here.
And Scorpio does inform us that all 3 of these points are exactly the same capture rate.
Okay, that's cool. Oh, here comes the pop-in from Sigma right on the enemy team. Great aggression from the soldier here. Seymour and Seffy taking out Kapow. Great moves here from the Beybladers team, but they're going to need to get themselves into a good position here, defending B from A, and then pushing into A as soon as they have enough players down. However, Kapow and Moranis, just went down, so it could be a huge opportunity here for the Beybladers team to come in and even up the score. And it looks like that's the opportunity they're going to go for. Mobility Gaming trying to defend here, but they are, of course, 2 down.
Well, what you gotta watch out for, though, is that every bit of damage from Mobility right now is golden, because they've got a medic, their opponents don't, and so actually they just completely
cleaned
out. Oh, and that's,
nicely done there. Just some patient play, knowing that the medic was down, deciding to out damage over time, and it's just the time, amount of time they needed here.
Now B and C both getting simul captured, so that's a new word I just invented for this map. Scorpio Uprising, you're not the only creative one out there. Just kidding, I could never do what you do. But actually, this is working really well for them so far. Neither B nor C is getting stopped. Kraka just got killed. Now, finally, I think they've stopped the cap on point C, but just barely. And so now it's A and B in the possession of Mobility Gaming, and a lot of capture time on point C.
Yeah, a ton of capture time on point C.
I don't know, Mobility, like, they could do it. Can't even talk. I want to say they could just make this singular focus to be go for point C, get the capture, and actually, with Sigma down at 99% and Deselect the only man left alive, I think that's what they're going to do.
I think the mobility game is going to take it to 4-2. Mobility Gaming, the team that took out, I believe, the Pinball Wizards on Gravel Pit, are just looking fantastic towards the later half of this season. Only one round to go. The momentum is squarely in their favor. And I think you might have to agree with me here that I think this will be a fairly straightforward round for Mobility Gaming, who just have to keep doing what they're doing.
Yeah, Moranis here is going to go take on... Actually, sees both scouts there heading towards point A, so he just says, screw that, I'm going to go help my team out at B, probably. And there you go. Actually, we're seeing the same thing happen here that the pinball... Or, I'm sorry, that laser beams are doing a lot, which is we see that the Beybladers are capping both A and C at the same time. C got stopped for some reason, though, and actually Aegis did too.
Yeah, I think that's a really good response here from the Mobility Gaming, is to try and stop those points from being captured, because now they have a point and the Beybladers do not.
Yeah, of course, there's no real benefit to holding a point, except that, you know, if you hold all three, you win, but until then, it almost doesn't matter. And BT is having to back away here. B getting captured by our Beybladers team in red. C is now getting captured by Mobility, so... I think Mobility will probably lose B, but they will hold on to C, and it's a good place to push from.
Finally, the Uber engagement comes in here as players drop mostly from the Beybladers team. I'm not liking the Beybladers position here. However, Zackal does go down, so it's going to be up to the last two players here from the Beybladers to try to clean up a little bit and cap this B point.
Yeah, and one thing I'll say is that I thought there was going to be a lot of crazy off-classing, and there just hasn't been any. Not even from Pure. So,
I may or may not have called that.
You might have done that. It's just Seffy and Seymour up, the soldier duo right now for the Beybladers. They did get Kraka spawning. But Mobility holds C. They actually hold B as well, I think. And A is nobody's. But A is gonna, I think, get captured soon, because there is a scout on it right now for Mobility. So this actually could put it away for the Mobility Gaming team. They just need to stop the cap on B, which right now they're trying to do. Zackal took a lot of hits there.
And Kraka and Scout coming in. Great Scout work there, taking out Zackal and Kapow. However, it's going to be up to BT to try and stop this B point. Oh, it doesn't look like he's really going to go for it.
Yeah, he realized he was not going to be able to stop that. He just went for the medic, and actually Sigma went down to like 20 health there. Mobility, they've capped C, they've capped A. The Mobility may actually lose C here to a scout cap, but now they've got Spanker on B. Can they stack this enough, actually? I think they might be able to, just to win it.
Yes, I think so. I think so. It's going to be super, super close here, and I think the Beybladers team knows it and is trying to get them off the B point. The entire dreams of this team for this map is all dependent on this B point here.
Wow.
C has been stopped by Kapow. Very beautiful demo.
Well, yeah, it is, but Moranis and Spanker actually just both did a great job taking out the medic there. Sigma is down again. Spanker finally eats a pill to the face and dies there, but that was a good run for him. Now C is still being held on by Kapow. Who is that soldier? I don't even know. And Zackerl. And there is an Uber for Zackerl now. All they need to do is cap B, and I think they're going to go for it once again. They can Uber into the enemy team at any time, but Rook is 3 against 6 right now. Actually, this is looking good for Beybladers.
Yeah, I think that... Oh, here comes the Uber pop on the B point. That's huge. They just need to get as much cap time as humanly possible on this point.
Yeah, it's not going to be fast enough. I think A... Well...
Mm-mm. No, I think it's going to be just in time.
You may be right. Yeah, here comes the big defense by Beybladers. Everything comes down to this. If they cannot defend that point, then they lose this game. And right
three
now...
Three down for each team. It's going to be up to this next pick here. Oh, too many down for Mobility Gaming. Clutch defense there from the Beybladers team. They need to go cap a point. That's not B. They need to take this opportunity and go right now.
And Rando already bombed in, I think, but Rando should not have gone by himself. Didn't get anything accomplished there, except actually to just slow his team down even more. B getting capped once again by a scout, though, and nobody's stopping it right now. There you go. Soldier finally hops on there, and once again, really, really close defense. There's the Uber. That's going to keep B defended for a while, and C is going to get capped by the Beybladers, so they're still in it.
Yes, great play here from the Beybladers. Great clutch end of... almost end-of-life play there. I mean, they were within milliseconds of losing this game. And instead, they're swinging this round back into their favor, holding 2 points. However, 4 down currently for the YMR team. The Beybladers team here.
Well, Mobility is finally going to finish off this cap on B, which is what they wanted to do all along, and they've wiped out most of the red team, although look at those quick spawn times. Sigma, Sephi, Seymour, they're all up now, and it's just C left. And once again, we're in that situation where Mobility wants to try and stack this point as much as they possibly can. They've got to watch out for Bombers, got to watch out for good defense coming in. But right now, Beybladers, I mean, they may start getting A-capped, and that's what they're doing with Kraka. D-Select coming in, trying to stop the cap on C, and might be able to do that because it's just Zacarul and BT left now. BT is actually trying to stop the A-cap, and now B's getting capped. I mean, this is just crazy action.
Yeah, it's going to be a pretty quick cleanup here for the Scout. BT-18, however, is just going to back off with that Equalizer. Probably a good play by him. Just leave that A point.
By the way, somebody was saying that I think Scout is actually Tyranny, which would make some sense.
Yeah. Oh, it's Tyranny, Sephi, Sigma. That's some three old names for an old team.
Mm-hmm. Well, right now, looks like A and C are held by the Beybladers. Just point B held by Mobility Gaming after they were so close to winning this game. They're still pretty close, and they are getting A-capped right now. It's being contested so far. They don't want to get caught in these tiny little choke points too much.
Yeah, they don't want to get caught in the hallways. They want to be cut out in the open where they have choice to engage or back out if they want to. Here comes the aggression from the Beybladers. Takes out Zacarul. Three down currently. Four down for the Mobility Gaming team. I think the Beybladers need to get some cap time down.
Yeah, that's what they're doing. They're going to get B capped.
But Mobility gets it with the C cap. I was a little confused as to what... I didn't think that was actually going to win them that game, but this map is confusing as hell for a caster. Fantastic play from the Mobility Gaming team. I have to say that this is quite an upset result here. The Mobility Gaming team just was not supposed to take out Sigma's team, the Beybladers. It was just... I mean... First the Pinball Wizards, then this team. The Mobility Gaming team is shaping up to be a very big powerhouse here towards the later end of the season. Let's see if they can wrestle their way into a playoff spot where all the records are completely reset and it's everything starts fresh and anew.
Yeah, guys, this has been amazing. Of course, I'm Salamancer. It was joined by Shadow Puppet. And, this was a hard map to shoutcast. I'm not going to lie. The action was, it was all over the place. And so we tried to follow as much as we could. If you guys have suggestions on how to improve our shoutcast on this map, do please let us know. You can drop us a line at the X Television forums. You can let us know right here in chat if you want to. I am actually going to go straight to bed because I have early stuff, and I think Shadow Puppet does too. But X-Time may still be reading for a little bit, so do hang out, do discuss it. We would love to see your suggestions on CP Stand-In. Anyway, that's going to be it for us tonight, guys. Thank you very much for watching XTV. Rock out.
Peace out, guys.